team from the Gladiator film. I'm going to explain all of the Maximus jokes in the Roman Empire and the fraudulent history of the Roman Church. And especially today, I'm quite triumphant, which is why today they have tried to shut down my electricity and gas. I had a visit from a team that were equipped with a locksmith to break into my house to shut down anything that I have going. Yeah, and all they have done this morning, I've spent 4 to 5 hours trying to make this preparation for the video. And outside I see this gang of thuggish looking people with unmarked vehicles, and they turn out to be the eviction agents who are rivals to G4S in that sector. And what they told me they were going to do within 4 days of our agreement with my wife and her solicitor, that we were going to share the divorce proceedings evenly, and that I've got access now to my massive £200,000 pensions. Yeah, the Jedburgh Sheriff Court, the same day that I wrote to the Queen, have issued it's a warrant this time, so that the locksmith can come with a thuggish guy from Cumbria, and he can break into my house, and they can impose on me the imposition of a metering system, which means that I have to purchase, I think, a little card. But this is the religious fraud and the banking fraud overlapping. It's now the unified Piso family crimes. Yeah, and when I found it the other night, I was absolutely delighted. Yeah, this now explains why the whole of Christianity interlocks with the massive global banking frauds for all of world history. And you know who the family is that is at the hub of that? Let me show you now the fine details of that. So, here we go, and there we have a declaration that those are Roman coins, okay? And the key is that Rome's a massive city, and they need to issue money so that the citizens of that 1 million plus city, even way back when, before Christ, was a massive place. Can you see the reaction to the clouds? We've just had massive rainstorms at Lord Sainsbury's when I went to get my lunch. Yeah, and what they've done this morning is, because all of my assets are locked up, is that they are now threatening to starve me to death. Can you see that? All of my joint savings, which are £10,000, you know, it's tens of thousands of pounds that we have at the bank, which is why neither of us qualified for legal aid, which is why my wife's solicitor's fees, yeah, but let's get to the hub of it. Yeah, it's a massive stitch up against the world's people, and all of it comes out today, which is why they've panicked. Okay, so there's, let's go to the top and let's just read down through it. Yeah, I've been intrigued by a concept of things that we used to sit on the, every person who was employed in indentured labour used to have Wally Duggs on their mantelpiece, and that's a greyhound figurine, and it's a joke about the human condition, the cats and dogs jokes that come into the Calpurnius Piso story. Yeah, and when I discovered, when I was looking up the Aryan master race, that that is a series of myths about gods and extraterrestrial deities, yeah, that are actually a joke about the whole of our religious base and the ordinary working people that are the slaves in the system, the slaves in the Old Testament. And let me just show you what I've discovered. Okay, so bizarrely, I found this strand under Wally Duggs. Yeah, the Duke of Roxburgh, when I asked him, did he understand? I saw him presenting a pair of Wally Duggs
as the prize if the sun's gone in. Did you see that? Yeah. So the Duke of Roxburgh, the last point of points that I attended, I asked him, what was the significance of Wally Duggs in Scottish history? Because he had just presented to the winner of the last horsey race across the hurdles at the point of points a couple of Wally Duggs. And I thought, ah, here's a civilised man, and maybe I'll be able to get an answer to that question I've been asking ever since I came back from Scotland, from New Zealand. And he said he had no idea. It was just a prize in the horse race. Yeah, that's Guy Innes Kerr, whose middle name means Jesus. Okay, and what we've got down here is the fact that the person who runs the mint in the busy city that is Rome, with over a million citizens, is Lucius Calpurnius Piso Frugi. Okay, so, and that is the Lucius Calpurnius Piso Frugi is the owner and the runner and the administrator and the boss at the mint in Rome. And Frugi means thrifty, and you can bet your boots that the Pisos are thrifty, because this now links them to the Vatican and all of the corrupted banks for all of human history. So they're the money lenders that Jesus warned us about. Do you see the gravity of it? Which is why they had to shut me down this morning and gag me on everything I'm revealing. I'm now talking to Callum Kerr, but because of the links to Guy Innes Kerr, one is ever so insecure that they might be prepared to starve the world's most innocent fraud researcher to death. Yeah, we've got a month to go until the assets that all that I own and I put entirely into the secure bank accounts that my wife is trying to empty, and until my wife actually gets access to those beyond the carve update, which is a month from the 6th of August, yeah? And the 6th of August hearing, they declared that everything was now amicable and all of it would be settled on a 50-50 basis, but still, for the whole of that period, the accounts are locked up. Yeah? So, this is the man who issues the coins, and let's have a look at the coins and guess what's on them. Okay, so this is the coins are the Trinity joke, because there's three of them, and guess what that is? It's the fucking Kelpie that they keep bringing into the Scottish legends. Yeah, it's been a couple of times in our hometown this year, and that's the joke about the Loch Ness Monster and the Kelpie icon and the beasts being the demons in our world. The humans are actually the demons in our world. So there's three of them for a laugh, and that's the Holy Trinity joke. And the ancient city of Rome was huge by any standards. Let's just read the text from Wikipedia. It's not actually Wikipedia, it's from, wait for it, it's from the British Museum, the imperialist hub for the English-speaking world that now steals from the whole world. And I'm trying to engage in open-ended discussions with all the referenced material. None of the sad bastards will talk to me, with the exception of the new MP for this region, Callum Kerr. He knows my power. Miss Tom is neglecting that, and she's in a very, very dangerous position. And I'll explain that later, because her name comes into this massive, massive theft project. Okay, so the ancient city of Rome was huge by any standards, approaching 1 million inhabitants by the late 1st century BC. Coins were in constant use and the demand for them was high, but the mint was severely limited in its output by the technology available, that of striking coins by hand. While modern mechanized mints can produce billions of coins a year, ancient mints struck each coin with the blow of a hammer, making production relatively slow and laborious. Because of this, the mints were often unable to produce enough low-value bronze coins, which were needed in larger quantities than the more valuable silver or gold coins. Can you see how gusty is it there? Yet the gods are absolutely delighted that I'm speaking about this now before my electricity runs out. They've left me with 25 quid on the meter. Allegedly. I have no way of knowing whether that's true. Okay? So, then the more valuable silver or gold coins. To speed up the process, coin blanks were sometimes cast in strips, like we've just seen, like this rare example, and then struck in quick succession before being separated into individual coins. This was an ancient attempt, and it sounds a bit like the shell game, doesn't it? At mass production to supply one of the world's first urbanized consumer societies with money. These bronze coins, known as, wait for it, asses. Do you see the significance of that now? That is the joke about Jesus, and I'll show you much more on that later on, because there I have all of the references behind this. So the ass on Palm Sunday is the Jesus joke. And the palms are a joke about the width of the female vagina. And all of it, all of these world leaders think is hilarious for 2,000 years plus. Okay? Were made in the name of the Roman Republican moneyer Lucius Calpurnius Piso Frugi. Yeah? I've got it sus now, and it opens up a whole new money stream of information. Yeah? And that now becomes, and there's the source, www.britishmuseum.org. Yeah? Right then. And the sun is flickering in and out, because that's the British Museum where the central banks were first sequestered following the Waterloo Triumph. And that is the beginning of the end of the prosperous world. Let's go further down and see what else I've discovered. Yeah, I'm just delighted to be able to present it to you. So there's the three hammer-produced coins again, with the Kelpie on the front. Yeah, and all the story of the church is driven by the threat of dragons and beasties in the local lake, like you've got in the Lord of the Rings film. And so they drain the lakes. And when they do that, and there is no fear-mongering anymore, nobody goes to church. Same at Moorbattle, in our local parishes. Strip of three bronze Roman bronze coins, Roman around 90 BC. So this is the creators of the Christianity fraud, 90 years before the birth of the fictitious Jesus. Same family, same fraudsters, massively influential in all of world history, right up to what happened outside my house this morning. A total breach of human rights. Yeah, and everything I tried to explain to them about my solvency, I showed them my pension documents, I showed them that the case was now being equitably shared, I asked them to ring my wife's sheriff, solicitor. They would do nothing. Yeah, and I've got videos of all of that, and you can see the individuals involved. And you can maybe give them a conscience from me. And they brought two policemen from Dunn's, which is the massive exposures I have made on Melrose and Porteous and the Dunn's interlocks to the McCalls of Monaco, JP Morgan, yeah, Michael Moore, the Parliamentary Foundation for Democracy Limited, and all of our massive democracy frauds. There is no money given to society any longer. Yeah, and you can tell that these people are behind all of it. Okay, so strip of three Roman bronze coins, asses. Yeah, they're absolutely ruthless at everything they kill in the missions and in the inquisitions. Yet they just laugh at the authorship of all the stories that they tell, and all of them are encoded with their numerical codes. Okay, so that's Roman around 90 BC from Rome, Italy, mass production at the Mint of Rome. Oh, we've just read that bit. I just wanted you to see the pictures. And down below, you see what the Rothschilds have already used as one of the world's biggest and sickest jokes. Because their version of the ass in rural Hertfordshire, where we used to live, is that one. Yeah, and I've told you about the trenches and the troops sharing the joke about the black bull asking why the zebra, which is the wild ass at the British Museum. Do you see it? Do you remember the story about Baron Rothschild being murdered by his ruthless family because he was an innocent person who was interested in naturalism and wildlife? And the joke is that the bull will rip the pyjamas off the wild ass and shag it relentlessly. And that is the joke that is shared with all of the people that die in the trenches in World War One. And what they have to write home is a tick box to say that I have shit in my pants, please send me some new underwear. And the whole thing is a massive joke at the war dead. Right then. So, we're down to the bottom of that little bit. Let me show you the Wally Duggs bit. So what I looked up is the Aryan Master Race, and I immediately got more pictures of wildlife or domestic pets. And they're incredibly like humans. Okay, so this is the Irish Wolfhound Times. Remember, I asked the Duke of Roxburgh, what was the joke about the greyhounds on every working man's mantelpiece? And when you see the working man and the lean and fit greyhounds, and you see the links to coursing, that's the chasing of hares. So the joke about Kristallnacht and the stories that were written and published openly on Radio 4, when I was so innocent that I did not understand any of this, Kristallnacht is like the hare coursing. Yeah, the hare with the amber eyes is a novel about the slaughter of the Jews in the Holocaust. Yeah, and this is the master race. What does it? Okay, Aryan on coursing, and it's full of really, really posh words, but it is really easy to see that the starving and lean people with all their ribs showing through their carcass, yeah, it is just sickly. Okay, by William Dancy, 1831. And it's all full of bullshit. The Cynegeticus was originally written by Arian in imitation of Xenophon's Treatise de Venietoni to supply the lacunae of that work in the particular treatment, particular department of coursing, that's chasing hares into a fenced up field that they cannot escape until they get chewed up. That's the Holocaust joke. Do you get it? And they share it with every one of the members of the indentured labour workforce as they give them, or not, the right to work every year at the hiring fair, and none of that is left in British history on the internet. I don't know why they're called Wally Duggs, okay? The manuscript, and it's ever so posh, seems to have been neglected in the Vatican Library for several years after it had been first discovered. So that's the Vatican that wrote the King Arthur myths that immediately after Calman Rothschild's visit to Naples and to Rome, they were able to interlock with the Rothschilds and officially declare it in world history, yet that in the lifetime of Calman Rothschild, that they were linked to the funding of the Vatican. Can you now see how the writers of the Vatican story were always involved in the issuance of money in the city of Rome? Can you see the sun flickering in and out? Let's see if I've highlighted any more. That's what I now need to tell the Duke of Roxburgh, but I want to meet the Duke of Roxburgh. I went to his house the other night and it is really sick. Yeah, I went to his house with all my finery on after coming out of the court and hearing that I was going to get all of that pension to myself. Yeah, and that's 200,000, and they're shutting me down and gagging me because this is what I do. Okay, this is the biggest story that has ever been told in world history. It's about the founding of the fraudulent religions by the same family that run the fraudulent banks in all of world history. Right then, let's see if there's anything else highlighted. Look it up for yourself, Aryan Master Race, and look at the pictures of the Dugs. Are there any pictures? Oh, there they are. Yeah, so that's almost a copulation scene, isn't it? Can you see their humanist ribs? Can you see their skinny legs and their ample thighs? And can you see the tenderness with which they are licking each other's ears? And the ears are a massive part of the joke, because that is the puka joke. Yeah, their ears are loppy, or their ears stand up, and that is the puka joke about all of the myths from all of the Grecian regions and all of the Aegean region that becomes the myths for the gods that get adapted, like the Egyptian myths, into the Christianity story. Okay? Greyhound puppies, a group in white marble in the British Museum from the ruins of Antoninus's villa at Monte Cagnallo. Okay? So this is the Antonine Nerva movement that broke away from Naples immediately after the New Testament was released, and immediately after they had several family members killed, because those family members described the main author in the biblical text, who was Arius Calpurnius, Nius Piso. Yeah, he's the man. And when Lucius Piso wrote about Revelations, he wrote in his father as the devil. Okay? And that's the ruins of Antoninus's villa at Monte Cagnallo. I did not get time to highlight any of this. I just want to make sure that before my... and all of it is a giveaway. Here's the Hamiltons of Centler Scotland. Mr. Gavin Hamilton. This is the people that Rudolf Hess came to visit in an attempt to stop World War II. And immediately Winston Churchill had him locked away so that the profiteering war could not be interrupted. Okay? This beautiful group of greyhound puppies was found by Mr. Gavin Hamilton in the year 1774 at Monte Cagnallo, part of the villa of Antoninus Pius. Yeah, that's the Piso moniker again. The popes are the Pisos, the moneylenders are the Pisos, and the authors of the Bible are the Pisos. Do you get it now? And they're really tight with their cash, which you can get from that name, which is, what was the name? The name on the back, it always reminds me of fruit. Anyway, let's get down, see if we can get any more pictures to sensationalise you with. And I don't know whether or not how the reincarnation works, but it seems likely to me that they believe in those days that humans that are poor and impoverished are reincarnate as dogs or cats, and humans that are filthy rich and are the world's owners are associated with the icon for the Piso horse, which is the Hippos name. And that is the joke that they're sharing here, that you're reincarnate as the Hippos, yeah, as the horse and the head of the cavalry. Yeah, and all of it is really, really sinister. And that one there in the Roman emperordom is the first one to convert from paganism and animism, which is the worship of animals for their innocence and their inspirational qualities, to the worshipping of the false icon that is Jesus, with the same initials as Julius Christ. Are you seeing the gravity of it now? Okay, let's see if there's anything else highlighted, or we'll just take you through the pictures and then I'll take you through some of the other shocking history. As you can see, the horse is pivotal. We told you the stories about the statues in Hoyk High Street and all around the world, with the horse rearing up, and the Lipizzaner's horses in Austro-Germany, where World War I was launched out of, being particularly gifted, and they're trained to kill the Futschalt soldiers with their hooves as they crash down onto the ground again. Okay? And there is the hare with the amber eyes, which is the Jewish nation and all of the poor people in the world, because that is the diaspora that they start before they start every great conflict. And in the newspapers today, they are still hitting on the immigration scandals that they totally plan and premeditate to keep our country in chaos and the whole world in chaos and fear. Okay? And it's Kant's Gracchus and Grains all indicated a supposed connection with Greece. Okay? All of the story is ancient legend, and all of it is just a series of sick jokes that we're the world owners, and we want to tell you about that in this encoded message with the images that laugh at your capacity never to have a life on the world that we totally own by fraud, and your soul is also in our hands. And that comes into the translation of the word piso later on, because in Spanish it translates as soul. Right then. Yeah, the sun is dipping. It's absolutely sick. And there's the Arch of Constantine. So do you get the picture? When Abelard Reuchlin talks about the legionnaires and all of the new Christians hiding in the catacombs for all of these years, it's Constantine. That's the joke. Yeah, he's not at all constant to his own religious beliefs that he was born into, that the sun god is worshipable and the animals are lovely and reassuring for all of the human race. Instead, he supports Christ and begins to crucify the Jews all over their vast empire. The numbers of the Jews dropped from 8 million to 3 million in 120 years when this family were writing the New Testament. And you know all about what happened in 79 AD when they released it and the Villa Papyri was buried in rubble under Vesuvius. That's why I know there is a God. And if you had just seen the storm that we had as I went for my lunch at Sainsbury's on the last of my budget that gives me the access to eating for a whole month. Yet I threatened to interrupt my wife's divorce case with a hunger strike. I may not need to do a hunger strike now. I will be sitting in the town square and outside the cop shop and outside Jedburgh Sheriff Court, getting there on my bike, because we have all our cars off the road. Yet everything that I earned has been taken from me because I'm a political activist. And a religious activist now, the whole thing is an interlocking fraud. Right then, let's make sure that we get the whole story told. So I'll leave the Wally Duggs thing and we'll go to another picture of their images. I thought I had a whole host of these. Maybe I have. No, only the one. So you can see that the apps and all of the technology and all of the stories that we get are still in popular culture as part of this Roman master race joke. Yeah, and there's the getting intimate greyhounds again, and I'm not sure why I've focused on that one. Now they will no longer fund the racing dogs. When they get too old for sex, the poor people have to adopt them and fund that too. Do you know that story? Yeah, my best friend that works for one of the big four auditors has now given up fishing. And I believe that will be because he realises that I'm on the right side of God's rules and how dangerous it is to stand in my way. He's followed me all around the country, yeah? And I now realise that he has now adopted a new set of behaviours, and that is really good, old friend. You know who you are. That's an outstanding example, and it's still really rare. Yeah, but the more the acts of God occur, the more the people will be driven into that panicky state. Okay? And I'm not sure. So now they have to fund the orphaned greyhounds, and the orphaned donkeys that used to work in the mines are in David Murray's field opposite the Scottish Borders Council, who have imposed the gagging order on me, and through them they have banned me from being a taxi driver. They have banned me from working in the taxi service. Yeah, and all of it is a whole series of Freemasonic crimes against the very, very few innocents that are left on our globe, because this is the team that runs every war to get rid of the innocent people and the poor people. Yeah, almost entirely now the survivors all around the globe. And you can see the scams in Christianity with the priesthood. They're not allowed to marry, so they're not allowed to have innocent children, and all of a sudden the innocents disappear. Right then, so Spanish translations. Okay, now I did this research almost a year ago and it's almost gone from my head, but I saw it again last night. And what you've got in the Lucius character, that is one of the names of that Piso. What was his name again? His name was Lucius Calpurnius Piso Frugi. Okay, so Frugi is frugal, tight with his dosh. Yeah, that's all of the world's money now. And what you've got in the Spanish translations for Lucius is the fascist word, because Lucius means look right. Do you get it? Yeah, the light of the world, and all of those stories and all of the frauds that are committed out of Oxford and Cambridge, it is a massive stitch up. So the other translation for the words from Google Translate in Spanish is, this is just one language, okay? So floor is piso, suelo, planta, pista, fondo. The word flat is apartamento, plano, piso, departamento, casa, superficie, plana, flooring, piso. This is why they have so many wallpaper and linoleum companies and decoration companies in my town. One run from the Cornish base, one run from my old friends in the pharmacy sector. Once I revealed their interlocks to the Taskers and the Dukes of Buccleuch, and she's had a horrible pathology, but she's getting slightly better. Yeah, flooring, puesto, soul. Do you get it? Yeah, saving your soul by adhering to the rules of these vicious, murderous bastards. Suela, linguado, planta, piso, earth, tierra, madreguera, globo, terraquia. Yeah, so we're now getting on to the whole globe jokes, and the jokes that Celine Dion and all of the New World musicians sing about the globalized things, and their videos are massive jokes at the world's people and their fans. Suelo, piso, story. Yeah, piso is also the word for story, which is the Christian Bible. It's their story, and the translations for that are historia. Do you get it? False historia. That's, I'm not sure what that is. Cuento, relato, fabula, so fabulous writings, science fiction, all of it is fiction. Novella, and also piso, and the word deck, because the deck chair is the joke about the warships and the kings and queens fighting against the poor people and sitting in comfort on the deck chairs. That is the Dukes of Cambridge, the Germans, who are fighting against the English in Gallipoli or in the Crimean Wars, and they sit on the deck chairs watching the bombardment of the poor troops with no cover, and I think it was 150,000 of them die within 8 months. Okay? So, it's really funny, because this is linked to the authors of the people who are prepared to get you to sell your soul and to give up all of your money and all of your life in a quest to believe that this person ever existed. And then you have to go all around the world in the missions. Yeah, which is why I'm really sad about the Jehovah's Witnesses, because they have missions in the Philippines, and they do not understand that the whole of the New Testament and the Jesus fraud is just that. It's a faked up story. And the Father God, when I go to the church every Sunday, often the sun shines through, because when they talk about the Father God and the things that happen with the real deities, the sun always shines through. When they talk about Jesus and all of the things that are cover-ups for the massive financial frauds all around the world and the individuals that engage in that, and many of them have body doubles planted, yeah, it's particularly prevalent at the Jehovah's. Anyway, so the deck translates as Haraja, Adorno, Diestro, On, Piso, Suelo, and the word tier is Nivel, Narada, Piso, Phyla, and Planta. Okay, I don't know what this next bit is. Oh yeah, the Lucrite thing. Yeah, do you get that now? That is the songs about the Air Force in America. Fly ahead and fly right and straight ahead. Okay? And what you've got there is that the noun for Lucius can be pike. Yeah? A vicious predator. Yeah? And this is the Piso families are vicious predators. They kill the emperors, they kill their own families, they get the emperors to sire the children of the women, and the women are Poppias, yeah, and that is the people, and Mariams, yeah, the whole thing is a joke, and the Mariam joke becomes what were Smarties, and they become M&Ms, yeah, because the Mariam is on each end. And all of it I've explained already. So the noun for Lucrite is pike, dolu, hasta, Lucius, stylus, lupus. Yeah, one of the diseases that my next door neighbour sadly has got, and she's a horse fanatic. That's the hippos addiction. Veratum. Okay, I wish my neighbours well. They're beginning to open up with me, and they know that because their children have epilepsy and because I'm a benign presence and I can help to cure things, they now talk to me openly all the time, and I've had fascinating discussions with them this week. But I'm faced with the prospect that I'm going to have to ask them to help me stay alive, because I may not have a budget in the second half of this month to feed myself. Okay, so this is the Antonine Nerva, and it gets ever so interesting. Let me just show you the evidence tabs before I start on these longer stories. Okay, so this is references. No, let's go through the story, because we can go to each of the references when it becomes relevant. Okay, so this is one of the characters, and he died in 101. So he's part of the Frugi team, yet the moneylenders minting team, right up to the end of the first century, after Jesus was faked up. His full name was Lucius Scribonius. Now this is the scribed joke that I've told you before. It's on my web pages, and it is a joke about the companies run by Shimon Peres and their evidence under a website called Scribd. Yeah? Which is about the statistics in the Holocaust. And the Perez family are massive leaders of the new nation of Israel, and Shimon Peres has been the longest serving prime minister for that nation. He lives his life in poverty in the desert. And that's the joke about a cow in Palestine is worth more than the whole of the desert. Okay? And he's involved in the massive laundering, and his family members live in Spain and they live in Latin America, and all of the art treasures end up in their galleries. It's on my website, just look up any of those keywords. Yeah? And Scribonius Libo Rupilius Frugi, and that I believe is the Rapala joke out of Naples that I shared with you in a video a couple of weeks ago, okay, was a different Suffolk consul, and the Rapala joke is that it has hooks, three hooks on it, the Holy Trinity joke. Okay, so this guy is an ancestor to Marcus Aurelius, and the timelines and the family trees take us all the way through this story, if I've got time, to Marcus Aurelius and to Commodus that was featured in that film. Yeah, that's that film. Okay? And the man, the story about Maximus, is at the end of this saga. Right then. So, he was one of the sons and among the children born to Marcus Licinius Crassus Frugi. Yeah, do you get it? The Frugis are the frugal people that run the print, the minting by hand, hitting with a hammer, pushing out those three icons of the horrific monster that is the Kelpie. And that is also a joke about the lake in Alba in Rome, where the Pope Benedict, yeah, the Nazi Pope, was placed in his safe house after they had gotten rid of him, because I started to reveal his massive frauds. Yeah, that's religious integrity frauds. The whole thing is a stitch up and a fraud for 2,000 years. Okay, so this guy's the grandson of Marcus Licinius Crassus Frugi and Scribonia. And his brother, Gaius Calpurnius Piso, you remember my videos on the several tiers of the family that got involved in the key period from the year dot to the year 140 AD, when I thought that they all left Naples, and it seems that many of them went closer to the mint. And it's really convenient to be close to the mint or the Bank of England, because you can fill your suitcase every day when you go home. Okay, and that's Nero that they murdered. The father of Frugi was executed by Nero. Okay, so you've got infighting and total treason, and everything is bloody and ruthless, and all of it is the moral base for the new religion that they launch. According to Augustan history, Frugi was of consular rank and refers to him as a former consul. Frugi served as Suffolk consul in Pliny the Younger reports him speaking aggressively in the Roman Senate in 101. That's like the 101st floor joke though, isn't it? Yeah? When they bring down the Twin Towers. And we've got Mindia Matilda. Yeah? All of the Australian jokes. Yeah? I've explained to you Scipio was the man who did the culling in the battles of Carthage. And that is Skippy the Bush Kangaroo joke. Frugi with Matilda had a daughter called Rupilla Faustina. Yeah, that's the Faust stories in popular culture. The noblewoman Rupilla Faustina became the paternal grandmother of Marcus Aurelius. Yeah, in that movie, the man who has a dream that is Rome, and the man that laughs at Christianity in The Hunchback of Notre Dame. He's more interested in the lusty women, and all of it is a stitch up. Right then, so we've got a series of very insightful references, because this is the people that I could not find. And we've got at the bottom, I think, a family tree. Aha! Okay, and it tells you that in the families, you've got a Cameron. I'm not sure where he is. I thought I had taken a still of that. It would be better if we can find the web page and look at it real time, because this is a hopelessly Did I cite the web page? No. So Frugi Cameron is Cameron linkage. Piso and banking. David Cameron's £1 million frauds in Hong Kong and all of the stuff that the official cover-up people for this spout all of the time in their investigative journalist frauds. Yeah, they just cover them. They just cover up these massive sins against the world people for all of that time. Now, I'm not sure. I did upload. If we go to the bottom, we'll find it. Let's go there and show you the family tree in higher resolution. Okay? Marcus Aurelius, 161 to 180, and here you've got Commodus. Okay, these are the characters in the film, and there's Claudius Pompey. Right then, let's see if we can find the link. Here we go, and we'll get the timeline so that you can identify the characters in it. And this is the story of Gordian. Look that up on Wikipedia if you need to, because it's the Maximus story, and it's a whole series of treasonous jokes that 2,000 years ago you might expect, but now when we're not allowed to smack our children, they're allowed to do to me what they have done in the last 10 days. Yet the world's most innocent man, upstanding and honest in everything I talk about, and they're trying to starve me to death. Okay, so there it is. Libo Rupilius Frugi died 101. Yeah, that's 40 years before I lost track of the Antonine Nerva dynasty, who remember go right into Constantinople so they can divide the war by religious conflict, and left into Ireland so they can do the same thing out of France, England, Scotland. Yeah, Canterbury, Kent comes into the story on the references bit, and the donkeys are all over it. Yeah, it's a vicious, vicious joke about Jesus, and I was an altar boy, and I'm a deep moralist, but when you realise that the whole of the world has been run this way, it is absolutely tragic. Right then, let's find the family tree and pin something on David Cameron. Okay, so the darker purple indicates emperor of the Nerva Antonine dynasty. So there's Titus, 79 AD. That is the year that Vesuvius erupted. Okay? There's Nerva, and there's Hadrian, and that's the people that began to get a little bit nervy about the revenge attacks on the people that they had murdered already. And here's the Patterson linkages. We've had several Patterson family funerals in my hometown. John Patterson is no longer talking to me, he's just spouting shit. Yeah, and all of it is a whole series of really serious treasonous acts, and all the way through I've suspected him of being a family relative of Paterculus with one T. And Sheriff Patterson in the courts, yet that has allowed them to declare that we are now settling civilly in the hearings that he has convened in a totally fraudulent way. Those videos come out this evening. Yeah, he's prepared to allow them to impose me no access to the funds that I put in place that mean that, yeah, we are ineligible for legal aid. And Cameron gets his brother legal aid on £5 million fraud cases. Yeah, because his brother is a lawyer. There's Trajan. Now, where was the link? There's another Patterson. Right then. And the Pattersons in my town are really innocent people. They're really nice people. Some of them are coppers. Yeah, and it's just amazing. The coppers that came this morning, because they were called out, because I'm a menace to everybody. I had to get my neighbours to come and watch that they did not scam me out of anything else. And blessedly my neighbours did that without any fuss, and they now understand everything that is happening to me. And I believe that that will mean that they have a more healthy future than the immediate past, because it's taken me ever such a long time to convince them that I'm an honest and open man. There's Hadrian, 117 to 138. He's the one that builds the wall all over Scotland. And when he comes, yeah, they have big quakes as well. They had a quake in Scotland along that fault line, yeah, in the Almond Valley, right across into Oban, in the same year. Yeah, because the team is global everywhere now, and all of a sudden, when that man Constantine comes along, they stop persecuting the new Christians, and presumably he got a massive bung from the moneylenders and the mint to shut the fuck up and to allow them to crucify the Jews instead. Can you see how it works? Okay, so where is the Cameron linkage that I saw this morning? It may be on that other family tree. So there's Matilda. It's actually Matidia Minor. And there's Arius Antoninus. All the way through, the Arian joke comes in. And for the ordinary people, it becomes the Greyhounds. And they become anti-Arianisms, because the Arian thing is so unbelievable that they're claiming that Jesus is actually the God in the skies. So they create a counter-movement to contest that, and it makes them look ever so innocent in the history of Catholicism. Yeah, and the whole story was written by them. There's a Lucius Commodus, Antoninus Pius, Lucius Aelius Caesar, Marcus Aurelius, 161 to 180 AD. Okay, I don't know where these people were at that time, but this is really useful because it's a series of hyperlinks. I can tell you where Marcus Aurelius was at that time. Well, obviously he's in Rome, but he's all over the Roman Empire, brutalizing everywhere he goes. Okay, and all of the fine art is fine art, and it's in the Louvre or the British Museum. The British fucking Museum. It's a series of imperialist culls that are totally vicious. And now all of the exiles from all of these places that are the hubs of power are now all through London or through Edinburgh, and they've corrupted everywhere they go. Okay, right then, so let's go back and let's look at that last tab on the and down below him we have Commodus. And I should maybe have gone to the bottom, but here's the Maximus story now. This is the Gordian tab, and I thought that I still did not find Cameron. Let's find him. What did I say he was identified as in the stories? Frugi Camerinus. Okay, somewhere on that family tree, if you look at the original one. Yeah, so can you see it? The current Prime Minister of the UK and the 30-year Prime Minister for Israel, Shimon Peres, all of them run the laundering. His dad runs the bank at Honkers and Shonkers. Yeah, and he's the current Prime Minister in charge of everything that happens. And I wrote to him on the Queen, and on the same day, their response was to tell Law Enforcement Scotland, which is the Jedburgh Sheriff Court, which is complicit now in all of the war crimes and all of the financial frauds against the people, including the energy frauds. And some of that data they allowed me to display. The rises in the energy bills are, it's 40% year on year. Yeah, it's absolutely ruthless. And the statistics policy units in Westminster, run by the Jew Klaus Moser, yet with massive frauds in the House of Lords, with the full support of Oxford, Cambridge, and the man that is the Christian preacher and the historian in global civilization, Melvin Bragg, is a great admirer of his. Yeah, that's how they falsify the statistics. I'm delighted to hear that Ed Miliband is being forced out of office. There is no integrity in anyone in that Parliament building, with the possible exception of Callum Kerr. But the peer pressure on him, if he supports me, will be immense. I believe that the gods will shield you from that, Callum, but I cannot guarantee that. And everything I do, I just want you to allow me to continue to do it. I can do this job on my own. I don't need money. All I need is sufficient battery power to fuel my TV, to fuel my occasional telephone call, and to fuel this. Yet my food budget is less than £35 a week. Do not mention the forbidden fruit. Right then. So, Gordian, the Maximus. So I still cannot see where I picked up Cameron in that story. And I thought I might have highlighted it. So there's the Pater one. There's the Nerva dynasty. Trajan. But because it gets all compressed in this format, it's very difficult to see it. So look it up for yourself and see if you can find him. Oh, Marcus Aurelius, he's highlighted, but Cameron is not. Anyway, Gordian and the Maximus story. Okay, so this is a child emperor. You've heard that story before in England with King James the First and King James the Sixth. I think he was somewhere between 4 and 6 when he was given the kingdom, and it means that all the corrupted advisors for the previous regime run the kingdom. So, Gordonian, yeah? And he is, the family tree to Marcus Aurelius is here. Oh shit, there it is. Right then, let's find that and let's see if we can find Cameron. I think we've just done this though. Sorry, I'm so traumatised by what happened this morning. And the police came from Dunn's. I shook their hands and they went away again. We had to wait 2 hours for that to happen. And it was all totally coincident with me beginning to put my camera on the shelf and to start making this video. They know what my research has been over the last 2 or 3 days because they monitor every computer in my house out of Chipping Norton, where my wife came from. Okay? And there's all the familiar names, but I cannot see. Oh, if we search for Cam, find C-A-M. Oh, it's run the second line. Okay, so Quintus, have you heard of Quintus in the movies? Yeah, the one who put the, who sent him into the forest to get this knife between his shoulders. Yeah, remember, sometimes the blade ices up. Yeah, the weather patterns reflect my every report, and the people in the supermarket look ever so sheepish now. The storm that we had before I went to get my lunch, or when I arrived in the supermarket, it had abated by the time I opened the doors and came out again. It's amazing. And it is really inspiring. Yeah, and the people that stand against me are in a really dangerous position. Not from me, but by the people that created our wonderful world. Okay, so Quintus, Sulpicius, Camerinus, Petticus, and the petty bit. I think I now understand some of the local behaviour patterns. It's amazing how these family names are still all over my hometown, and that applies to the Warner brothers and all of the things that I've told you about World War I, World War II, all of the German monarchs. All of them are represented. Some of them live in Eccles. That's the ecclesiastical joke. And I spent a fascinating 20 minutes with a woman that sounds just like Woody Allen from the Scottish borders. And she wants me to come to dinner and have a cup of coffee with her. I do not think I dare do that. Okay, right then. So, the noblewoman Rupilia Faustina became the paternal grandmother of Marcus Aurelius. Yeah, and on the story goes, and he plays King Arthur. Yeah, and he's in all the movies about the Notre Dame fraud and all of the fraud all across Western Europe and Eastern Europe into Constantinople and into all of those warmongering threats that something sinister is coming at us because the people that worship the Messiah that we were told never to worship, and all of it is written by the people that run the mint in Rome, in Naples, in Frankfurt, in Vienna, and in London and Paris. It's a huge stitch up. The only transition I have yet to find is the transition from Frugi to Rothschild. Okay, I'll get it eventually. Yeah, I need to try and feed myself. If any of you want to get in touch and you can lend me something or you can send me a food bundle, it would be really greatly appreciated. Yeah, I don't really need feeding. Yeah, all I need is the information, and all of it is coming out. Yeah, that's Miss Patricia Tong, that is Sheriff Peter Patterson, and all the interlocks I've told you about the treasonous selling of Scotland. Yeah, and everything that I asked of my wife under oath, they refused me access to asking the question. Right, so Gordian. So this is the story about the child emperor, and his 22nd of April is reign to 29th July 238 as Caesar to Papinius and Balbinus. Now that's beginning to be the joke about the Lake Alba. The linguistics are totally twisted, but when you see the letter B at the beginning of a word, it's the second launch of that joke. Okay, that's the B Overy, Madame Bovary joke, over and over and over again. Okay, so the Alba is the lake in Rome, which has the elite mansions where Pope Benedict the 16th is housed. And Pope Benedict was picked because Pope Benedict the 15th is the Nazi Pope in World War I. And Pius the 12th is the Nazi Pope in World War II, and it's massive genocide every time. And when you've got the word pie in it, it's an absolute confirmation that the same family is behind the mint, the Nazi gold, and all of it being laundered into their havens, all of which are completely owned by them because they own every central bank on the globe. And every religious mind in Catholicism and in everybody that adheres to the Christianity myths, every denomination is being defrauded by them for 2,150 years. Right then, so his predecessor was Papienus and Balbinus, and this is now the beginning of the jokes about the Dalmatians and the puppies and the Balbinus stuff. And what you've got is successor was Philip the Arab. Yeah, and the Arabs link in weakly to the G20 because they are really, really rich because of what God gave them, but they do not have as much wits as George W. Bush and Tony Blair to steal from the world's people, so they fund everything. The Jews do the creative thinking, they coerce every politician on our globe, and they tie them into Lubavitcher movements that mean that no one gets a life because they're all friends of Israel, and the whole plot is written centuries ago and it is totally decrepit, and it means that the whole world is run in chaos. Okay, so the wife is Furius, a relative of Furius in the Piso family, and that is the joke about Gladiator's furry shawl. Yeah, and when Mandela was buried, everyone was in fur coats, just as an icon. And when I saw the storm at lunchtime, it reminded me of the massive lightning storms we had the other day, and I was able to converse with someone in the supermarket about the use of a selfie stick, because there were two fatalities when we had the last lightning storm, both in Wales, in the vast tracts of land owned by the Prince's Trust, and both of the profiteers that died with lightning strikes were using selfie cameras on the end of a conducting pole. And God has a huge sense of humour. And I hope the guys that visited me this morning from the Duns police, so we had five people around my home making sure that I could not make this video inside that home. Yeah? Two policemen from Duns, and that is the frauds that I've told you about Melrose and Porteous, into Monaco. Yeah, and we won't tell you again. It's all on my website. Okay? Marcus Antonius, Gordian's Pius, birth to accession, Caesar, Marcus Antonius Gordianus, Pius Augustus. So everywhere you go, this is of the emperors, this is not the moneylenders or the mints now, or the authors of the New Testament, it's the emperors. Yeah? And they murder ruthlessly, and they fund everything that happens globally, and that goes right on until we get to 1949. And when the reparations come, they manipulate all of the inquests, and all of that is all over my life story now. In only 4 years, it's simple to know what they do, yeah? And none of our press will do anything about it, because that is Murdoch's press. Okay, another coin. In 235, following the murder of Emperor Alexander Severus, that is in Abelard Reuchlin's story, okay? In Germany, in Mainz, the capital of the Roman province of Germania. And do you remember in the Gladiator movie about his German friend who's massive saying to him, so you were the head of the legions in Germany too? And there's a little shallow smile on his face. And all of it is mass slaughter against people that are just fighting to defend their own territory from people that are thousands of miles from home. And it still happens every day of every week. And we cannot smack our babies. And God bless my wife for saying that I had never ever been violent. And he would not let me talk about the attempts of her and Dr. Fingland, who's the school governor, to get me sectioned. All of it is a vicious, vicious story, and all of it they will be really ashamed of really, really soon. And it might be better not to take an umbrella because of that story I've just told you about the selfies and the conducting handle. Okay. Maximus was on the verge of marching on Rome. Okay, so let me introduce you to Maximus, because we've skipped a bit. In 235, following the murder of Alexander Severus in Montagu in Mainz, so this is the launch of the FIFA federations in Germany. Yeah, they're fighting back now. The Romans are so far from home, they can barely feed themselves, as if they were in divorce proceedings. Okay? And all of the wounds that they get in all of the battles, they die horrible deaths because there's no health care. And this is the rules that the false Jesus gave us to love your neighbour everywhere. In the following years, there was a growing opposition against Maximinus in the Roman Senate and amongst the majority of the population. Okay? And the elder Gordonians died, but public opinion cherished their memory as peace-loving and literate men. Yeah, that's a menacing statement now, what you know about the world's authors and the inner circle that understand all of these frauds and continually cover them up. And appointed those people came to visit me this morning. Okay? Victims of Maximinus's oppression. Okay? Meanwhile, Maximinus was on the verge of marching on Rome, and the Senate elected Papienus and Balbinus as joint emperors. These senators were not popular men, so I think that the youngster is still in charge aged, I think he was 12 or 11. Yeah, these senators were not popular men, and the population of Rome was still shocked by the elder Gordian's fate. Okay, so that the Senate decided to take the teenager Gordian, rename him Marcus Artonius Gordianus, and the women in the pipe band were all over the supermarket yesterday, and they're from Gordon, and that's one of the names of the Scottish tartans, and it's the Black Gordons, and they've got a regiment with the names, and all of it is taking you back to these ancient jokes. And there's no way of knowing whether these are truths. Yeah, but the names that tie the Pisos to the mint, they cannot deny that now. Yeah. And that's the reason that they want to divert me so much, because they know that I cannot get a lot of documents lodged into my library of research when I'm contending with their treason outside my door. Right then. There's where we say the Gordon women were in the supermarket yesterday, and it's now the Jedburgh Brass Band. Yeah? So the woman from Gordon plays in the Jedburgh Brass Band, and that's the Jedburgh Sheriff Court that have taken my electricity from me today. I've got 25 quid's worth to continue to try and save the world. Okay? At the age of 13, he became the youngest sole legal Roman emperor throughout the existence of the United Roman Empire. Gordian was the son of Antonia Gordiana, an unnamed senator who died before 238. Okay? And so there's the murder of Severus. And Maximus Thrax was acclaimed emperor. In the following years, there was a growing opposition against Maximinus in the Roman Senate and amongst the majority of the population of Rome. Again, there is no way that I can comment on the accuracy of any of this, but can you see the proximity of his name to the freedom fighter who is now a legend? Yeah, and there is no Maximus the Revolutionary anywhere in any of these stories. Okay, so what else? So this other tab is interesting, and it ends up with him being deserted and killed by the Praetorian Guard, and all of the Praetorian Guard just keeps changing sides. On July 29th, Papienus and Balbinus were killed by the Praetorian Guard, and Gordian proclaimed sole emperor. Due to Gordian's age, the imperial government, this is familiar from the beheadings of all of the queens in all of the sectarian violence in Scotland and in England and in the Tudor days, the imperial government was surrendered to the aristocratic families who controlled the affairs of Rome through the Senate and also the Mint and also the Vatican. Do you see it now? Right then, so here's another story on lots of fillers and diversions. So this is another tab on another series of families. This time he was born around 30 AD, and one of them is Marcus Licinius Crassus Frugi, consul in the year 27, and Scribonia Magna. This is the links to Magnus, Magnusson, and Sally. I now understand why she is the boss and the presenter for Songs of Praise, and why she writes about the utility of piss. Yeah, the utility of the Piso joke to take over world ownership, and she pretends that she has been defrauded of her pension fund. Yeah, and she fronts up on the religious fraud that is Songs of Praise for 20 or so years. And I fear for her future. She's a really genuine looking person on air. How they can do this, I do not know. They have no conscience at all. Okay, Lucius Scribonius, this is the scribd links to Israel, the Nazi loot, and all of the fine art treasures all over Latin America. and all over Paris and all over Spain and all over Portugal. Gaius Copernicus Piso Crassus Frugi Licinius Licinianus. Can you see everything? They intertwine the names, and all of a sudden, somewhere or other, the Rothschilds appear, and they appeared, I believe, if Andrew Carrington Hitchcock is correct, they were the Bears, yeah, in their early days, east of the Black Sea. Then they became the Rothschilds, and they opted to become Jews so that they could use the anti-Semitic protection racket, yeah, to shield themselves against committing the massive genocide that is the Holocaust against their own people, but only the poor. Brother of Licinia Lupilius, okay, and Lucius Calpurnius Piso Frugi Lucianus Marcus Licinius Crassus Scribonius and Gnaeus Pompeius Magnus. Yeah, can you see the Magnusson name coming in now? Yeah, and I'm not sure what else we've got on here, but let's go down and see if we can see anything sensational, because I've got the stories about the donkeys and things. So the devil masters, what is that referring to? So Lucius was the man that introduced the devil into the Bible as his own dad or his own grandparent, yeah, and he had him killed for that. Okay, and that is the devil masters, that is the legal presence, and Sally Magnusson represents the media. So in today's video, I'm explaining to you how the law does it, how the issuance of money does it at the mint, how the religious mind control and the owning of the souls, which means floor or linoleum, yeah, they've got it all in a series of interlocking jokes that leads to world ownership. Gnaeus Pompeius Magnus, son of Frugi, the moneylender. Yeah, and Sally's pension is bust. Yeah, and there's a whole series of little diversionary things from modern day Daily Herald and Pennsylvania newspapers. Yeah, they panicked when they saw I was onto this. They tried to shut me down completely. Yeah, and anybody could call at my door like they did this morning with a gun and end it all at any time. Thank you to my neighbours for rallying round and witnessing everything that they tried to do, and my constructive response to try and get them to talk to Jedburgh Sheriff Court about the new constructive outcome that all of our wealth that has been locked up and sequestered in a totally fraudulent case against me could now be released to me to let me have a life again. But instead, it's starvation for me. Well, yeah, it's gonna be good for my waistline and my quest for the one true woman. Okay. Oh, loads and loads of diversionary stuff. Okay, so Scribonia Magna, little stories on all of these. I'm going to read them all tonight if my electricity holds up. Can you see the predicament that they have placed me in? To do another treasonous act and to cover the truth about the way our country and our world is run and where all of the funds go. Right then. So, Crassus was the grandson of Triumvir, yeah, the Holy Trinity again. Triumvir Marcus Lucinus Crassus, and the last known direct descendant of his grandfather Frugi, served as praetor and then later as consul with Lucius Calpurnius Piso in 27 under the reign of Roman Emperor Tiberius. All of this is written up in the Ivantec document under Abelard Reuchlin's really fabulous Piso Bible fraud documents and YouTube videos. Look up Faking the New Testament in my website index, and you'll get 10 or 12 little sad saga.